prompted by an article written by Heather Knight, a roboticist and researcher at Stanford University, titled Tesla Autopilot Review, Bikers Will Die. Myself and my trusty sidekick, Mike, took it upon ourselves yet again to test out Tesla Autopilot against a real, live human. Here are our results.
Success, full stop. It had you as a car for a second there.
Success. It detected and stopped for the bike in the middle of the lane, though it saw the bike as a car, most likely due to it being long ways in the lane. The width reflects back to the radar more so like a car than a bike.
It wouldn't even let me get to 25. It caught me so quick, it wouldn't even let me get to 25. The race started slowing me down way back there.
Success. This time, even though I was quite far back when I activated autopilot, it detected the bike so quickly and soon, it wouldn't even let the car get to the set speed of 25 miles per hour.
This time, you showed up at a car after I completely stopped.
Yell louder.
This time you showed up as a car after I completely stopped. And now it says press accelerator to resume. I'm gonna try it. Yep, okay, it wanted to take off. So after it stopped, after it asked me to press to resume, it would have went right through you, but it did stop for you first.
Success! The Tesla's radar saw Mike and bike and stopped for him. It appears due to the bike being long ways in the lane between the radar and the camera, it had detected at a distance. However, became unsure of itself once stopped. Teslas are programmed on the side of caution. As such, required the driver to check for vehicles and people before resuming course.
Got it! Pull off to the road! Alright, Roboticist. But this time you didn't show up at all on the radar, or on the screen. What? Oh, the car stopped, yeah. But once you got far enough to the side, I probably would have hit your foot if I would have let it keep going. But it thought you were far enough off the road. But it did slow down to an almost stop. I mean, if someone doesn't catch that when they're driving, I mean, they're freaking sleeping at the wheel anyways.
Success and partial fail. Interesting result. Somewhat expected, though, based on our tests from last year. The Tesla Model S slowed down and followed Mike. Once Mike moved over to the shoulder of the road, the car attempted to resume its course and speed. Unfortunately, at this point, the radar could no longer see the bike, and the side sonar did not appear to detect it quick enough before the driver took over, and could have resulted in a minor. Though, also note, we are testing using Autopilot 1.0 hardware. Autopilot 1.0 sonar has a maximum range of 4 feet, or 1.22 meters, whereas Autopilot 2.0 hardware, what is being used currently in Tesla production for the Model S, X, and 3, has a range of 8 feet or 2.44 meters. May be enough to have detected the bike from the side. Also, hardware 2.0 incorporates the use of 8 cameras, giving a 360-degree visual, whereas Autopilot 1.0 only has a single forward-facing camera.
Mike's off on the side of the road. Let's see what happens.
Pass, fail. Pass, the Model S detected the bike and slowed the vehicle down. Fail, The vehicle did not bring itself to a complete stop. Instead of a complete stop, the autopilot panicked and sounded the collision alert. In this case, the swerving, or drunk driving, of Mike brought him in and out of the radar's detection zone. As such, when the car was too close to maintain a lock on him, sounded the collision alert for the driver to take over. Complicated. I, as the driver, became nervous. I touched the steering wheel. Result, deactivating autopilot. However, after touching the steering wheel, autopilot deactivates and becomes TACC, Traffic Aware Cruise Control. TACC is similar to autopilot, only does not steer the car. It can still bring the vehicle to a complete stop and activate collision avoidance. In this case, TACC slowed the vehicle down until the bike was clear of the vehicle's path. Then the car resumed its speed.
Describe what happened. Let me put my thoughts together. Autopilot gave me the warning tone, and it also slowed down significantly. And then once again, natural reaction, once the alert tone went off, then I hit the brakes at the same time. But it did its best to bring it to a complete stop, but it was too close for me to risk testing it if it would have been accident mitigation or accident avoidance. So would have it been less severe of a hit, or would have it completely stopped, but it was too close to be able to give it a straight answer on that one.
Mixed emotions. The car did see the bike last second, and it did attempt to slow the vehicle. However, it did not do so quick enough. The car could detect the bike at a far enough distance away. However, it took too long for the car to be able to determine if the bike was going to cross paths or wait for the car to pass. By the point it made a determination, accident avoidance then became accident mitigation, or in other words, the car did its best to reduce the damage that would be caused from an inevitable collision. My conclusion, while autopilot is not full autonomous, it has remarkable collision avoidance features, especially for only having autopilot version 1 hardware. With the version 2 hardware out, and the software updates bring all its hardware online piece by piece, the only thing that can happen is more improvements. While shaky, I need to say the only way autopilot will kill bikers is if the driver of the car is drunk, completely distracted, misusing autopilot as if it was full autonomous, or asleep. Used as designed, it will save lives. Of course, the famous words, you can't fix stupid. So, someone being stupid, whether from the driver's seat of the car or on the bicycle, that can't be accounted for in every single case. As such, someone will eventually get creamed. Used as directed, lives will be saved.